was terrible, wasn't it? It's time now for Smart.
Jay, what are you doing?
Oh, watching telly. Smart's on in a minute, but I can't find the remote control.
Jay, Smart's on now.
Right, pay attention. We need to test your knowledge of art to see if you was an expert in your field.
Oh, how tiring.
Shut up. No conferring. Now, who painted the Sistine Chapel?
Oh, I did that. Very hard work it was, too.
Have you gone completely berserk? The answer is Michelangelo.
Oh, he only helped with the ceiling. I had to do the skirting boards.
Be quiet. Now, which artist in a moment of madness cut his own ear off?
Oh, Edward Scissorhands?
Right, that's it. I'm stopping the test. You is too stupid for words.
Oh, thank goodness for that. Now let's relax over a nice lick of paint.
Very smart indeed.
Hello and welcome to Smart. On today's show, we've got...
Josie, look, I think I found the remote control.
Hello? Sorry, you're breaking up. I can't hear you. Hello? Hello? Sorry.
I think we're going to have to do something about this.
What? Oh, excuse me.
Hello? Hello? Sorry, I can't hear you. Josie's just taken my phone.
So, how can we stop this from getting into the wrong hands? Well, how about making one of these handy holders? I'll show you how. First thing you're going to need is an old glove, and we're going to fill out the fingers and thumb using pipe cleaners and cotton wool. So, fold down the wrist of the glove so that you can easily access the finger of the glove. There we go. And thread through a pipe cleaner, making sure it gets to the tip of the finger, and then take a ball of cotton wool and flesh it out. Now, you're going to have to use your thumb to really push the cotton wool down to give it that oh-so-realistic effect. There we are. Now, I'll show you one more time what I did, because I've still the thumb to do. So, find the opening for the thumb. And there it is. In with the pipe cleaner, right to the tip, and then a ball of cotton wool to stuff out the thumb. There we go. Now, with the ends of the pipe cleaners, once you've done all of your fingers and your thumb, I'll show you what I'm doing. I'm just bending it down and twisting it out of the way, twisting them all round together so that it's nice and safe. Then we can get on and stuff the palm, again using an enormous ball of cotton wool. So in that goes. And there we have it. A fully fleshed out hand. Now we need to make the hand stand up, and how I'm doing that is I'm using this weighted down jar which I filled with stones to give it a bit of weight. Then it's pop the glove over the top like that, make sure you pull it right down, and there you are, a standing hand, or a handstand if you like. Right, to make it look realistic it will need fingernails, so I'm using some old false nails. On they go. Now, I've decided that this hand is my Peggy Mitchell from EastEnders hand, so I'm going to make it glamorous like she is. So on goes the red fingernails, like that. And she's going to need some jewellery. First up, put a nice big bangle, stretch it out a bit, pop it in there. That looks flash. Now, you might not have any old jewellery at home that you've gotten from Christmas crackers or whatever. So look what I've done with this one. I've made this ring using a strip of foil, coiled it around and popped some beads on. There we go. And I think I'll put it on this finger. Once you've done that, you need to flatten out the palm so it's ready to hold that remote control. So just really press on it, curl over the fingers. There we are. Like that. Now, you might not want to make a Peggy Mitchell hand for watching those soap operas. You might want to make this rather glamorous golden hand all ready for watching an award ceremony. Or how about this one? This will be good for a wildlife show or perhaps a scary movie. Well, this one seems to be done. Now I know that my remote control will always be in safe hands. Over on Smart 1, we look to the skies with Ray Drawbridge. But here on Smart 2, it's time to return to Garth Kensip at the World Indoor Paint Drying Championships.
Yes, remarkable scenes here. You join us at a very tense moment as the top two gladiators from the paint drying world meet for the very first time.
Hello. Well, what a week it's been, starting with Sunday, with gradual outbreaks on Monday the following day. However, this new pattern has emerged quite recently, which we can take a closer look at. Push 5 pipe cleaners into the fingers and thumbs of an old glove. Use cotton wool to pad out the glove until it looks like a hand. Stretch the glove over the base until it completely covers the jar. Decorate according to personal preference and open out the palm. And now you'll have somewhere handy to keep your remote control. And the outlook for the rest of the day? Well, it should stay quite good for the Indoor Paint Drying Championships and many more.
Oh, and Burridge is using an artificial drying technique. And yes, the referee spotted it. So Burridge on a yellow card, gripping stuff.
Now, Rachel Brooks from London is suffering for art. She's at great pains to find out how to draw teddy bears. Well, Rachel, suffer no longer. I'll show you. All you have to do is draw a teddy skeleton, like I've done here, this cluster of circles. And then fill in the outline with this nice spiky texture, which you're using as its fur. Now, you may have seen this technique that Jay used to draw Otis. Let me just go all the way around this outline of circles. Nice little tufty mane. And then all you have to do is give a very simple cartoony face with a muzzle. Add a bit of detail. A nice plump tummy. And there you have your teddy bear.
How do you draw an ear? Asks Emily Sharp from Surrey. Well, if you look at the ears, no two are the same. For instance, Josie's and Mark's. Now, if you're translating this into shapes, I would do it in a series of circles, one bigger and one smaller, a bit like Mark's teddy bear. And then, with another pen, I would go over the top of that shape, and that should give you an accurate kind of shape of the ear. Now, the inner ear is the tricky bit. On some, they go like this. And they kind of curl all the way around like that, or they might go round, a bit shorter here, a bigger part there, and kind of come round like that. It all depends on the ear.
On the smartphone now is Alice Buick from Cardigan. Hello, Alice.
Hello, Josie.
Now, I hear you have an art problem. Tell us what it is.
How do you draw ripples on water?
Has that been causing you problems?
Yeah.
I think Mark has the solution.
Yes, I think I have the solution to your watery problem. All you have to do, Alice, is make sure you're using blue paper, and then start by using two colours, like I've done here. And then begin by doing, if you like, a spiral. Or these sort of concentric circles getting bigger and bigger. Just add a few extra little ripplets there. And that's the answer to your problem.
How was that, Alice?
Fine, thanks.
Thank you for your question. Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye.
So, if you're angry with your art or you have a smart tip to share, make sure you let us know.
Time to step into your art world now with a walk around the gallery.
Now, Alice Vera has sent in this lovely pencil sketch. I especially like the way she's made this tower look curved. Liam Shears has made this collage by cutting up one picture and making a new one.
Ta-da! Rohit Gohill has done this excellent sunset. It's hot out here.
Smart sketchbooks are on the way to all our featured artists. Sadly, we can't return your artwork, but if you'd like to see your work in the gallery, then look out for the address at the end of the programme.
Of that. Nope, I haven't turned over a new leaf. What I've got for you is a really fun pack make for you. Look at this. Start off with a white bit of card and some leaves. And what I'm doing here is putting some acrylic paint directly onto the leaf. And what you can do with this, which is another good trick, is you can start mixing your colours directly onto that leaf. Get it covered nicely, bring it over to your card, lay it down, and press it down. This is a roller I got from an art store, and they're very, very cheap. Look at that! Lovely. I'll show you what happens when you use another leaf. Look at this. I'll use some of this colour. And you can mix it again directly onto the leaf. Put a bit of lilac in there. And let's see what happens here. Now, if you don't have a roller, you can always do this. Put a bit of scrap paper over the top, give it a light press, and hey presto! Let's give another one there. Lovely. Let's try another leaf. Oh, this is fun. Right, let's go for some orange on this one. And you can just keep using the leaves over and over and over and over again and experiment, have fun. Look at the different prints different leaves make. Let's give one of these there and one there. Lovely. Now, if you notice, I'm leaving a lot of gaps here and just leaving the ribs of the leaves. The best way of explaining that is to show you another one. Look at this. White bit of card. If I grab a leaf and paint white paint on it. Here we go. In fact, I can do a quick little trick here. I can mix some beige and some white together. So we get a bit of a nice mottled effect. Spread it all over the leaf. That's it. Whoa. Get it all mucked in. All over those nice ribbed sections. That should do it. Nicely covered. Now bring it over to the card. Bring over our piece of paper. Put it on top. Give it a nice press down. Make sure all the edges are done. Let's have a look at what we've got here. Now what we've got
is a white leaf print on white paper. Now, you can't really see much there, can you? Now, for the next stage, the most important thing is to make sure all this paint dries. That reminds me, the other really important thing is... And if you remember that, you'll go far in life. Now it's all nice and dry, I'm going to totally ruin my picture. Here I've got some black Indian ink, and this stuff is permanent. What you do is you just spread it directly over your picture. That's it, nice and loosely. Get it a nice thin coat. We don't want to splodge too much of this stuff on. A little bit in the middle there. Lovely. Let's ruin our next picture. Come here. Now, I'm leaving the edges nice and kind of blank. I think it kind of gives a nice border there. Let's spread it all in. Ah, yes, that's what I like to see, a nice ruined picture. Yes, I've gone completely mad. Right, now, it only takes a moment or two for this stuff to dry because I'm going to be bringing it over here to give it a good wash. Yep, I'm mad. Just look at this. Ah, that's what you're up to, Jay. They're all crying out. You can stop halfway through if you want. Give it a little brush over like that. It helps some of the ink come off. And give it a final wash. Look at that. See what I mean about using light colours? That really has worked. Let's give this one a go. It's bath time for you. Now, the reason why this happens is the ink sticks to the paper very, very well, and it doesn't stick to the paint that well at all. So when you wash it off, it all comes off. Now let's give this one a little helping hand. The brush really helps lift the ink off the paint. And give it another bath. Look at that. What a lovely, colourful autumn scene. And this card is so heavy, it shouldn't wrinkle up too much and should dry quite flat. I think I'll leaf it at that.
Face it, where else could you find such a great set of prizes? And they might put a smile on your face if you can answer this question. Which famous portrait was made from 6,243 pencils earlier? A, the Laughing Cavalier, B, the Mona Lisa, or C, the Mona Lot? If you think you know, then phone 0891 339 944. Get permission first, and then you're laughing.
And he's done it again. Burridge has gone berserk. He's got to go. What was he thinking? The answer is, I don't know.
Oh, we don't want to watch this rubbish.
But it's the final of the Indoor Paint Drying Championships.
But I want to watch the end of Smart.
Oh.
Oh, no. Ah!
Next time, you'll need PVA glue, a round margarine lid, and bright acrylic paint. And if you'd like a fact sheet or have a smart tip for us, then write to Smart, PO Box 5053, London W12 6AW. One final make for you here. I'm rubbing an old household candle on a plain bit of paper and give you a nice good coating of wax. And once you've done that, find yourself a nice image in a newspaper. I've got a good one here. Put your paper on top of it, and with the heavy end of a good glass, give it a nice, good, solid rubbing. And when you've finished doing that, you should get yourself a very good mirror image. Chance to see your own artwork in print. Go on, give it a go.
What we need round here, plenty of get up and go.
Oh.
That little mouse was racing, and so am I. I'm going to race through some birthday cards before the one and only TTs. That's the Teletubbies, by the way, just in case you didn't realise. Right, now the first one is the raccoon from Pocahontas. No, it's not Rocky Raccoon. It's this lovely, sweet little raccoon. Isn't it nice? And they're here to say happy birthday to Kelly, who is four today. Happy fourth birthday, Kelly. There you are in the picky. Have a lovely day. Lots of love from Mummy and Daddy, and also Sam as well. And they say, have fun at your Pocahontas bouncy castle party today. Wow.